Hi, today I'm going to be doing another fast and simple card. This is the second one. I'm going to be doing a series on these fast and simple cards. It'll be over a long period though. So first, I'm starting off with this Paper Smooches stamp set. It has these really nice animals. That's why I got this stamp set from Paper Smooches. Mainly just for those animals. I didn't really care about the words as much. I just really like the animals, so I just thought of getting that for the animals. So first, I'm going to be using this sheep from this stamp set. This is going to be my main focus. I did use a lot. I just got this stamp set this past week, so I just started to use it. This was kind of one of my first tests. It was my first test using this sheep stamp. So this is how it's going. So I'm stamping this in Versifying Onyx Black ink. And I'm just stamping this onto some regular white cardstock. Now, this is really fast and simple. You're not going to need that much supplies. And I'm stamping it in Versifying because I am not going to be doing so much Copic coloring. Because usually I don't stamp my animal images in Versifying just because Versifying doesn't work with Copic markers very well. But I'm not going to be doing that much coloring, so I wasn't worrying anything about that. Now, I really like this stamp set from Paper Smooches. It's actually my first stamp set from Paper Smooches. It's called Party Posy, I think. You can check that on Paper Smooches later. So I have this Glitter Ritz glitter. I just got this as well. And it's actual micro fine glitter. So it's a super, super fine glitter. It's way, way, way thinner and finer than regular extra fine glitter or anything that you can, other glitters. It's Glitter Ritz, and this is actually in the warm highlight. I really wanted the cool highlight, but they didn't have at the local craft store that I went to. So I just ended up getting the warm highlight, and this is kind of like my first test using the Glitter Ritz. Plus, it's my first test using this stamp and doing it this way. So I'm first starting off with, this is a two-way glue pen, and you can get them in all different forms. This one is in the chisel tip. There's also broad tips, and there's you can even get some that are just regular pens that instead of ink it's glue. So there's many different ways that you can do this. You can also apply a liquid glue or glossy accents or anything that you want to adhere the glitter. I just thought that this was the fastest way and the easiest way to adhere the glitter without any big mess. Plus, I didn't want it to be too dimensional, so I thought that this would be a really easy way to do that. So I just used a two-way glue pen. I spread it over this entire sheep's his fur. And then now I'm taking, this is the Glitter Ritz glitter in the warm highlight. You can see how powdery it is. And the one thing about it is you are going to want to be very careful, because this is super powdery, and your whole workspace might get a little glittery. So if you are kind of worried about that, then this might not be the best product for you. So it will stick to your hands too and stuff. You just got to make sure you wash your hands very well afterward. Now, I did get some glitter where I didn't want it, so I'm just going to be using this X-Acto knife. I'm just going to kind of touch it up. Some of the glitter won't come off in the places that I didn't want it, but some of it will while it's still wet. So try to do that as fast as you can. I did color this sheep's nose pink, and I didn't like that. So I'm going to color it gray and black. So this is first N8. It's a Copic marker. I mostly have the sketch markers and chows. I just like the brush tip that on one side, and then I'm using 100, which is black. So as you can see there, that's the finished product. It dried, and you can see that nice shimmer glitter, which was really simple. So now I'm taking, this is Glossy Accents from Ranger. I store mine with a pin in it, and I know certain people had problems with the pin rusting and their Glossy Accents getting tinted yellow and stuff like that is happening. So after that, I did take out the pin. I don't have the pin in it, but so far it didn't give me any problems. But just to be safe, I'm not doing that anymore. So now I just put the glossy accents over the eye, and I'm going to put it over both eyes, and you can see here, this is the finished product. And you can see that glitter, it's glitter, you can really see how fine it is, and how really sparkly and really nice that the finished result gives. So first, I have this thin tape that I have shown in previous videos. It's a really, really thin tape, foam tape, which I really like using. Now, I adhered the black piece using that foam tape, and then I also adhered the white piece onto the black piece using some foam tape from EK Success. So I really like that tape because it's really thick, just like the American Crafts. But I wasn't able to get the American Crafts one, so that's why I got the EK Success one. They're pretty comparable prices. And I took out that paper pad from KI Memories, I believe. And that's a paper pad from Walmart, so you can get it at any Walmart. So first things first is I cut out that piece, that chevron piece. And now I have this wood grain washi tape. So now I put that down that one layer, and then now I'm doing the second layer of the exact same pattern. So the washi tape rolls, they usually repeat the patterns. So you just gotta find the pattern again, and then overlap it, and it'll give a perfect darker washi tape. So I really like doing that for certain washi tapes that aren't very defined, and I really like it to be really defined. Now I'm taking this American Crafts glitter ribbon. I really like this glitter ribbon, it's really bright and bold. The only thing about getting the ribbon is that you do have to tape it with some strong adhesive, but as long as you're okay with that, then the ribbon would be best, because the ribbon is opaque. I believe that the tape from American Crafts isn't as opaque as the glitter ribbon, but I don't have any of the tape, so I'm not exactly sure, but that's something that you can try. So I just put the adhesive on the back of the ribbon, and then I'm placing it and wrapping it on the card like that, and then I'm just going to use that same strong adhesive and then put tape over the entire back, and then glue that onto my card, or onto black cardstock, and then onto my card. And then here's the finished product. Hope you like it. Thanks for watching. Please leave your comments below, and have a great day.